Sandman Stories Presents Tokgaebi and His Pranks. Tokgaebi is the most mischievous sprite in all Korean fairyland. He does not like the sunshine or outdoors, and no one ever saw him on the streets. He lives in the sooty flues that run under the floors along the whole length of the house, from the kitchen at one end of it to the chimney hole in the ground at the other end. He delights in the smoke and smut, and does not mind fire or flame, for he likes to be where it is warm. He has no lungs, and his skin and eyes are both fireproof. He is as black as night, and loves nothing that has white in it. He is always afraid of a bit of silver, even if it be only a hairpin. Tokgaebi likes most to play at night, in the little loft over the fireplace. To run along the rafters and knock down the dust and cobwebs is his delight. His favorite game is to make the iron rice pot lid dance up and down so that it tumbles inside the rice kettle and cannot easily be got out again. Oh, how many times the cook burns, scalds, or steams her fingers in attempting to fish out that pot lid when Tokgaebi has pushed it in. How she does bless the sooty imp. But Tokgaebi is not always mischievous, and most of his capers hurt nobody. He is such a merry fellow that he keeps continuously busy, whether people cry or laugh. He does not mean to give anyone trouble, but he must have fun every minute, especially at night. When the fire is out, how he does chase the mice up and down the flues under the floor and up in the garret over the rafters. When the mousies lie dead on their backs, with their toes pointed upward, the street boys take them outdoors and throw them up in the air. Before the mice fall to the ground, the hawks swoop down and eat them up. Many a bird of prey gets his breakfast in this way. Although Tokgaebi plays so many pranks, he is kind to the kitchen maids. When, after a hard day's work, one is so tired out that she falls asleep, he helps her to do her hard tasks. Tokgaebi washes their dishes and cleans their tables for good servants, so when they wake up, the girls find their work done for them. Many a fairy tale is told about this jolly sprite's doings, how he gives good things to the really nice people and makes the bad ones mad by spitefully using them. They do say that the king of all the Tokgaebis has a museum of curiosities and a storehouse full of gold and gems and fine clothes, everything sweet to eat for good boys and girls and for old people that are kind to the birds and dumb animals. For bad folks, he has all sorts of things that are ugly and troublesome. He punishes stingy people by making them poor and miserable. The Tokgaebi king has also a menagerie of animals. These he sends to do his errands, rewarding the good and punishing naughty folks. Every year the little almanac with red and green covers tells in what quarter of the skies the Tokgaebi king lives for that year, so that the farmers and country people will keep out of his way and not provoke him. In his menagerie, the kind creatures that help human beings are the dragon, bear, tortoise, frog, dog, and rabbit. These are all man's friends. The cruel and treacherous creatures in Tokgaebi's menagerie are the tiger, wild boar, leopard, serpent, toad, and cat. These are the messengers of the Tokgaebi king to do his bidding when he punishes naughty folks. The common everyday Tokgaebi plays fewer tricks on the men and boys and enjoys himself more in bothering the girls and women. This, I suppose, is because they spend more time in the house than their fathers or brothers. In the land of rat-tat-tat, where the sound of beating the wash clothes never ceases, Tokgaebi loves to get a hold of the women's laundry sticks, which are used for pounding and polishing the starched clothes. He hides them so that they cannot be found. Then, Daddy makes a fuss because his long white coat has to go without its usual gloss. But it is all Tokgaebi's fault. Tokgaebi does not like starch because it is white. He loves to dance on Daddy's big black hat case that hangs on the wall. Sometimes he wiggles the fetish or household idol that is suspended from the rafters. But, most of all, he enjoys dancing a jig among the dishes in the closet over the fireplace, making them rattle and often tumble down with a crash. Tokgaebi likes to bother men sometimes too. If Daddy should get his topknot caught in a rat hole, or his head slip off his wooden pillow at night and he bump his nose, it is all Tokgaebi's fault. when anything happens to a boy's long braid of hair that hangs down his back and makes him look so much like a girl, Tokgaebi is blamed for it. It is even said that naughty men make compacts with Tokgaebi to do bad things, but the imp only helps the man for the fun of it. Tokgaebi cares nothing about what mortal men call right or wrong. He is only after fun, and is up to mischief all the time, so one must watch out for him. The kitchen maids and the men think they know how to circumvent Tokgaebi and spoil his tricks. Knowing that the imp does not like red, a young man, when betrothed, wears clothes of this bright color. Tokgaebi is afraid of shining silver too, so the men fasten their topknots together, and the girls keep their chignons in shape with silver hairpins. The magistrates and government officers have little storks made of solid silver in their hats, or else these birds are embroidered with silver thread on their dresses. Everyone who can afford them uses white metal dishes and dresses in snowy garments. Tokgaebi likes nothing white, and that is the reason why every Korean likes to put on clothes that are as dazzling as hoarfrost. Tons and mountains of starch are consumed in blanching and stiffening coats and skirts, sleeves and stockings. On festival days, the people look as if they were dipped in starch and their garments encrusted in rock candy. In this manner, they protect themselves from the pranks of Tokgaebi. The end.